Let's make sure
I don't give a damn what I say.
Make sure the audio levels are nice. Oh, yeah, I hear you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Doing the damn thing.
You know, a lot of Venezuelans are in...
Can you close that door?
In Colombia.
Actually, yeah. I don't want to see the nice daylight. No, I got to be locked in my dark room. So the conspiracies can start.
Venezuela!
No. You say it Aurora, Colorado.
Aurora, Colorado.
Yeah.
Aurora, Colorado. In Aurora, Colorado, North America.
There's a lot of Venezuela.
There's a lot of Venezuela.
Yeah.
Venezuela is going through many monetary issues.
Monetary change.
I believe the value of the dollar has decreased. Thousands, like,
really old.
Like, I think, like,
that's not good.
And tell me if I messed up, I could be wrong, but I think Venezuela's like they use their money to sit on now, like, they use their money as like napkins or some shit. Like, it's over.
I did hear about this.
Hyperinflation.
Let me see. Venezuelan hyperinflation. I can't spell. There we go. Look, it comes up in Google very quickly. And there's, yeah, I see what you're saying. There's just like pictures of people just with their money.
Just with with stacks of money. And yeah, exactly. That's how much a piece of chicken's worth. Like, what? And so places like Venezuela, this is where Bitcoin is a great case study.
How so?
Because you can, if you have no value in your dollar, you can start investing in Bitcoin, like the country, as well as like people. And you can use that as a point of exchange or rate of exchange.
Instead of your currency, which is failing.
Exactly.
Right.
And it fluctuates, but the money at least will always mature on a regular time.
Well, on a global scale.
So if you get in now, even if you put
this is
30
like,
billion in and that only equates to 20,000 GDP or something, it's still...
Right, but this sounds like what... Fair, it's a good idea, but it sounds like there's a lot of steps into getting like, oh, I have...
Type in Venezuela Bitcoin.
Venezuela Bitcoin. Oh, actually, hold on. Before I do that, let me read the hyperinflation thing. Venezuela has experienced hyperinflation, a period of rapid and severe inflation since 2016. The hyperinflation was caused by a number of factors, including printing money. The Venezuelan government
printing money.
Yeah,
that's so foreign. They're the only ones that do that.
Yeah, nobody else does that.
If you do that, you're a dumb fuck.
Yeah, and your national debt would be outlandish.
Yeah.
Printing money. The Venezuelan government printed large amounts of money to pay for expenses, which is quicker than borrowing or getting money from taxes. Yeah, it is. Currency controls. The government set a fixed... Currency controls. The government set a fixed exchange rate and made it difficult to exchange bolivares for U.S. dollars, so they wanted to keep their ecosystem only in their shit. Economic sanctions. The United States imposed economic sanctions on the government and President Maduro. Oh, and didn't he just win
Maduro
the...
Maduro is wild. And they didn't they just take his plane? I think they just, like took his plane in, like, America. Like, well,
didn't he just have the issue with the election?
Maduro's always had issues with...
Like, but he won
the past 10 years of my life, I hear Maduro's name creep up every year and a half. And he's doing something egregious. And there's always a picture of him wearing glasses eating a succulent meal.
How does he always make it out so well? He's Maduro. Let's see.
There is a country that's adopting Bitcoin. I it might not be Venezuela. I completely...
Let me see. I want to see what picture you see of him eating the succulent meal. He's just like... I mean, that looks like a guy you can trust. I don't know what's wrong with you.
Are you being sarcastic or
I'm being very sarcastic?
I'm looking at his face and there's like There's nothing about his face that's like you can't.
It's
trust
a little
him.
Winnie the Pooh-ish.
He looks like Pablo Escobar. Like that's what I imagine Pablo would look like.
He seems. I won't lie. His face looks like.
But I think that's racist for me to say.
His face looks like. He looks like he would be fair.
He looks like he fucks. Like, well, yes. He looks like he still fucks. You know what I'm saying? He's not like an older guy that's just chilling. He has a pinky ring. He fucks.
He has a pinky ring. He does. He really does. He has a pinky ring with the
Rolex. Come on. The pinky ring and his... And I think in the other picture, he wasn't wearing his wedding ring. Player. Look, go back.
He's always yelling.
But look. He's not wearing his wedding ring.
Oh,
but
wow.
He got that
the pinky
ring on.
Well, the pinky ring don't move.
The pinky, yeah. But the,
is it not on that one?
Maybe the pinky ring moves.
Look at that watch, though.
Yeah, no. What is that, a Hublot?
Yeah. But look. But they money ain't worth nothing. Huh. His money worth something. His money worth something.
Well, you know, because Nigeria is, like, rich in resources and everything. And they, like, totally should and could. A lot of places in Africa are rich in resources.
Oh, yes, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, rich in natural resources.
Yeah, well, but I think it's...
There's so much disarray.
I think it's a mixture
and
of
so much
corruption. Yo, you can't tell me the people who send you a letter for an African prince to a motherfucker all the way over here, those same groups of people who are in power over there aren't just being like, natural resources, take them all.
Let me tell you how funny God is. My entire life, I've been making fun of Nigerians for being scammers.
Mm-hmm.
Come to find out, I'm Nigerian.
So why haven't you been scamming?
Maybe I have.
When you are one of them, you don't see it.
You don't see it because it's just.
I'm
in
just
me.
Getting what I'm owed.
It's in me.
I'm just getting what I'm owed. I just thought that this was. It seemed fair to me.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're going to send the money, please send money.
Please send.
Also, Venezuela President Nicolas Maduro proposes rethinking the crypto path.
Yeah. No, but there's actual country in South America.
South American country crypto.
El Salvador.
Oh, El Salvador.
Yeah, El Salvador is using Bitcoin. They also are powering Bitcoin by their volcanoes because, you know, it's
the mining
energy. So if you can find a way to take that unlimited energy and use it and run it to run Bitcoin mining, they have Bitcoin.
Wow, official currency, I see.
Yeah.
Wow. So, yeah.
They're doing it. So, like, we'll see.
It's a small scale, so you can test it.
It's a good case study. And we'll see whenever we bomb them, whenever we're like, okay.
So, we're going to need you to just transfer to this wallet right here.
All of it.
But these are national resources.
This is all we have.
Hey, all of it.
Oh, no.
Hey, we're doing this for democracy. We're spreading fucking democracy.
You're polluting the world.
Whether you're volcanoes.
By mining all this Bitcoin. But sir, it's the cleanest energy they ever made.
New York Times. Is volcanic energy... as bad as radioactive energy? Find out below. Oh. Well, you know, we've all been hearing about this volcanic energy, and it's just...
I hear it's just destroying the world, destroying the atmosphere. They have children.
They have children inside the volcanoes. And they're scooping. But the lava's so hot, it burns.
They don't have protective gear.
No, they don't.
That's how you get the black lung.
But here's what we're going to do.
Well, we don't care.
But no, it's okay. We're going to send them.
We're going to save those Venezuelans.
We're going to save them. We're going to send them.
South American babies. South American babies.
South, North, it's all America, right? It's all America, right?
It's all America, right?
It's all America, right? Say it's not all America. Right?
the fuck?
Shit is crazy. That's how they're going to, oh shit, that's how they're going to flip it on us. You know what they're going to do? They're going to take the immigrant conversation and flip it on its head. How are you? American. How are you worried
South
about
South America, North America?
Yeah,
it's America.
It's all America.
How did that happen?
Well, from what I understand, which I need to look up, but Spain.
So Spain did that.
Spain came over. That's why you have Mexicans, because Spain's went over to that part of, from what I my understanding, they went over to that part of North America, and they basically ruled it.
It's so funny.
Like slavery all over again.
It's so funny, and I love that you said that's why you have Mexicans, because we separate these people, but it's their, like, this is all their land. They were all roaming Mayans, yes. Mexicans, yeah. All that. How did we come over here and separate they shit? Like,
well, like I said, I think, well, I see what you're getting at. Like, y'all were already doing this. But I think it's one of those things if you are...
Native Americans. Right. It's all the same shit.
But it's all the same shit because they're doing the same shit within their ecosystems. So what we did was we came... Not we. What they did is...
Sometimes I be claiming America. Yeah, because it's American. Well, like, I can't... I'm American.
Yeah, but I can't say us because...
Because you didn't.
I still would have been I still would have been a slave. So that's how I kind of look at it.
We
like,
can't even, like... We can't even enjoy colonialism. Like, we can't even be like,
yeah,
we took over.
We conquered y'all.
Slave.
Yeah, I would have been conquered. Conquering's not so good, huh?
We weren't on that side of the argument, no.
But okay. That's literally what happens even with Native Americans. Like they all had slaves. They all had dictatorships. They all had hierarchies. They all had. Oh, this country came over here and, like, you know, France and all these other countries were doing shit too. The British were figuring out America. Like, it was just all this, you know.
I wonder what facts we spew are lies.
What you mean?
Like, I wonder, because, you know, history's told by the victor.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So I wonder what parts of reality that we are like, no, this is what happened.
Oh, okay.
That they blatantly made up. Like the fact that I was looking at a map and the North America is bigger than Africa on so many versions.
And that's not true. I gotta get some tissue. Hold on.
Yeah. Oh, well, Maestro's going, so I'm gonna keep this ball rolling. So I want to talk about Bo DeMeo, because Maestro doesn't necessarily know about him, but there's a show called X-Men 97. X-Men 97 was released on Disney Plus, the showrunner, his name is Bo DeMeo. He's a writer, great writer, because X-Men 97 is top-tier television cartoon Marvel. Best X-Men. Like, that's like, they took X-Men, the animated series, and, like, turned it into, like, they updated it so, like, the action's amazing. It's, like, he put his foot in the shit. He's a great writer and storyteller. Right. And then he just got fired, like, 2 weeks before the show aired. And then everyone started watching, and they were like, nah.
Something's off.
Yeah, because this is perfect. Like, right. And it's been so long since Marvel's produced something that universally everyone's just like, nah, this is it.
Right.
So everybody's like, nah, this is it. And then they was like, why'd they fire him? And I said the same thing. So I decided to go to his Twitter.
And the stuff's just up on his Twitter.
He's just like he's a bodybuilder. So like he's always wearing the tiny tank shirts and stuff.
Yeah.
But you go to the Twitter and he's just like naked, only wearing the tank, but it's like cut right before. And you're just like, that doesn't seem very Disney.
And why did you not, how did no one see this before or care or?
I don't know. And maybe
or tell
that,
him, hey.
And maybe that was them trying to be inclusive. Maybe they, not trying to be inclusive, but like, they're like, he's great. Yeah, he has an OnlyFans, but.
I mean, what does that mean? Yeah. Playing that card.
You know, what does that mean? You know, and I'm of accordance. Yes. What does that mean?
Right.
Work your, if you good work, fired that man. And now I can't help but think, what could he have done to make them niggas that mad? And then, so now they're saying, oh, he was had egregious behavior at work. Yeah. And I'm starting to see leaks of them saying, oh, he was sexually aggressively texting. And this is allegedly, because I'm
right, right.
You're not suing me, bro. Sue Disney. Don't sue me. I'm just.
I got nothing for you.
I'm not trying to. I like your work. Like, not all your work. Not all your work. Not all your work. But I like your Disney work.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's the only one you know about.
That is the only one I know about.
Yeah. He was on the X, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, X-Men. X-Men. Oh, no.
That sounds all bad.
He was making Magneto gay. Like, no, he didn't make Magneto gay. But, like, in the X-Men, Magneto was fucking rogue. And that was supposed to be, like, his daughter figure growing up.
Really?
Yeah, because Rogue, and one of the books, like, Rogue is, like, Mystique's daughter or something.
Mystique's
like that.
The blue one, right?
Yeah. Anyway, he made Professor Xavier and Magneto pretty close to gay. Like, you're watching and you're like,
you two don't usually interact like this.
They're brothers. You're brothers. Like,
oh, so oh,
it didn't go there, but.
It alludes.
There's just scene. You know when you're
is it
watching.
Like, is
scenes.
It like that short? That short film we watched at the film festival. Remember? So we watched a short film where it was this like teenage girl, and she was on a vacation.
Yes.
Yeah. She was on a vacation with her friend's stepdad, right?
Yeah. And there and her.
Oh no! Her
friend's
dad
and stepmom
and stepmom and. Her and the stepmom had all this weird sexual tension. And
okay,
energy.
So I don't know if my male brain turned it into weird sexual
tension.
No, because
I asked like two people. I was
and
like,
they, yeah, and,
this but, is weird, right?
And everybody else was like,
because she said, I like playing in the gray area of, and we all were like, yeah, there's a lot
yeah,
of gray
he was
area.
Being freaky. Because like, she was like, yeah, I like playing in the gray area. But, this was really just to show power dynamics and how you wanted to.
And she said this from an experience I had when I was younger.
And then I was just like,
okay.
You got to, I'm not going to say it.
Something. But something see, happened. But the movie didn't seem like she didn't want it to happen, though.
The movie seemed like she was.
Yeah. So
it was
maybe,
very gray.
Very gray. Like it
because it seemed like she
the
took
adult
the man.
Was taken to. The adult was going too far.
And then the little girl took command and changed the roles.
Yes.
And then the adult was doing what the...
And they were kind of like, huh.
And they were like, and I was like,
what?
Right.
Then it was just over.
I was like, this is grooming. I was like, this is grooming.
This is a grooming movie. Not a goofy movie, a grooming movie.
A groofy.
A groofy movie.
Oh no. Okay, yeah. So Bo DeMeo, I don't know what the hell you did, but he just released a statement and he was like, I got all the receipts applied to my OnlyFans. And I was like, well, I'm never gonna know.
Oh, he's smart.
Is that smart? Because now, because before I was like, I was saying shit like,
this is last
hey,
hurrah shit though, like knowing like, hey, I'm cooked, so
Yeah, that's a little bit of bread. Mm-hmm. But it's like Nick, the news reports are just gonna go take it and report it, but I just because I was sympathetic towards him, and I was also like, hey, I don't give a fuck what he did.
He did this right.
Hire him the fuck back.
Yeah,
and just put a leash on that nigga or something.
He might like that.
I bet.
Not in the workplace.
Put a leash on this nigga in some way. Because okay, here's my thing. I'm a victim blamer when it comes to men.
What you mean?
I'm a victim blamer when it comes to men. Like, Let's say Bo DeMille was being aggressive with people on staff.
If he was doing it to men.
I'm going to fight you, bro. Like, there's right. like...
There's
like,
an unspoken code of like, this doesn't... This can stop whenever I
make it stop.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I understand women. Women, like, nah, bro. Like,
well, I feel you. It's like we have a problem in a cubicle job.
Yeah.
And you go to HR or some shit instead of just talking to me.
Yeah.
It's like, my nigga, what are you doing? What are you doing?
I went to HR when I was on Joker, but that was because a lady was fucking with me.
Yeah, and that's smart. Yeah.
I was like, yeah, no, I'm not.
But if it's a dude, I'm just going to come talk to you. Like, yeah, yeah, I see what you're
especially
saying.
If you're making sexual advances at me.
Oh, I'm going to let you know right now.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, okay, because like, all right, if I have a superior and they're treating me a certain way, like being rude to me, you might have to let that slide.
Yeah.
Take it on the chin. Do what you got to do. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Tuck it. But if you're like making sexual advances to me to the point where I feel comfortable, it's not going to get to the point where I feel uncomfortable.
Right, because I'm going to be like, hey, man, you need to cut that shit out.
Yeah, bro. Yeah. Like, yeah. I'm not going to
go ruin your whole career.
I'm not about to ruin your whole career.
I think what I said earlier, though.
Because maybe they were friends and maybe the person was trying to make him feel more comfortable than he, you know.
No, listen, what I said before this, though, I think there's a line, right? Like, when you are a criminal of sorts, we can really cut ties. If you're just doing weird shit, what constitutes as weird? There's a lot of gray area there.
There's a lot of gray area.
But if we say that you are sexually aggressively texting people, whatever the fuck that means, okay, well then, like, now we can, like, cut ties with you and, like, you have no get.
Yeah, no, if you're, like, yeah.
I think that's part of it.
I think in me saying what I just said, me saying, like, I think that's my first thought. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, when I actually go in and I'm more sympathetic and thoughtful towards things and everything. Yeah. But my first thought is, you're not doing that to me? Like, the fuck?
And just also as a human being, how do you let something get so far? But that's the same with the Louis C.K. type.
I was literally just about to bring up the Louis C.K. and what Dave Chappelle said. He said,
you got to hang up the phone. Like, what are we talking about? All right, I can understand, oh, this shouldn't be happening. Also, you know, if you can talk to him on the phone, you can also say, hey, dude, this shit's not cool. Stop. Hang up the phone. I'm pretty sure he's not going to call you and do that again. He's going to be ashamed and embarrassed, and he's going to probably apologize and send you some money.
Mm-hmm. Now I have you. If you're a woman, you have every right to file that complaint, do that, especially if you have a working relationship or something like that. But then there's also like the weird area where it's like people are friends, especially in that world, because like they go to the comedy store together. Like a lot of the writers and stuff like that, they've probably done coke together like a couple times.
I see what you're saying. This isn't the weirdest thing we've probably been in the same room doing.
No, well, we're happening to be on a show together now, and I don't know how to, or I haven't, or not me, but Louis C.K. or somebody is like, he doesn't know how to adjust or won't adjust. And like, we've been.
But
know,
also, I feel like it might be one of those things, like, I mean, it's another one of those cliche lines, but it's like, you didn't say shit. Like, you never really said, like.
You never said you didn't.
Yeah, like the odds of, like, for example, there's probably a few different types of people. There's somebody who just sits on that phone because they're just like, okay, this is weird, but I don't want to get fired. There's somebody who just hangs up and then acts like it didn't happen. There's somebody who sits on the phone and laughs and doesn't think much of it. But all of those people can, whenever they feel like it, use it against you.
Yeah.
And that's the only unfortunate, because here's the thing. Then there's somebody who's going to say something, and like I said, he probably just won't do it again. But it's because it's also like, I don't, you shouldn't be doing this, but at the same time, it's like, it's adults, right? Yeah. So like everybody should have some cognizance of, hey, no.
And then also he's a,
like, he's a cool never not, guy. Like, he's who, not, who, no, Louis, I'm saying Louis, like, he's not like,
but he's never not portrayed himself as a creep. Like, everything that he was accused of doing, he had a stand-up about it right. years before that came out.
Right.
He
right.
had some type of joke about it.
Right.
So when this came out and they were like, Louis would be on the phone just jacking off, I'd be like...
That sounds very Louis of him.
Did he have a bit about that?
Like, that's not on his television show.
Bro, in his television show.
Was great. He had Lucky Louis and then he had Louis. Louis was fantastic.
Was fantastic. Like, Louis was so... Because I'd never seen a show.
Louis.
The episode when he was at the art gallery and he said, "Don't press this button," and he pressed the button and it's just a sound of him screaming, "Nigger!" And the girl he's with just walks away. And he was like, "I didn't say that." He's like, "The button said that."
I can see his face too. I didn't say that.
But then he'll have something as hilarious as that, and then have the Robin Williams episode where it's just dark, and they just went to the funeral of one of their dead friend, comic friends or something.
Yeah.
And it's nothing funny about it. Louis is a genius.
No, he's amazing.
I'm just really sick of all of our geniuses, or my geniuses, or the people who I like. Not all the people that I like are predators, but like, what's going on?
A large fraction.
This thing on this. I guess you're supposed to.
I wouldn't do that if I was you.
Oh.
Why it says.
Fun fact, she's the voice of Bobby Hill.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yep, because she's the one who dates Runkle on. That's her, right?
Yeah.
She does Runkle on Californication.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's the voice of Bobby Hill.
Wow.
She's incredible.
Press.
So you press a thing because it says press? Mm-hmm. You would not have survived the camps.
Yeah.
What? It's...
Dude.
It says press.
Go ahead.
Why would they make it say
press? Press the arc button.
Press the arc button.
Nigger.
No, I didn't say it. I didn't say it. It's the button.
It's the button.
Okay. No. Wait a second. No. Wait.
Okay. I love Louis, man.
Yo, he's hilarious, bro. You know he grew up in Mexico?
Yeah, he's Mexican.
Yeah, I know. It's insane.
He's a ginger Mexican.
He's just so white-looking Mexican. It's so odd.
Like we said, it's all the same.
It's all America. That's the name of this episode.
It's all America. Wow. It's all the cover art has to be crazy. Bald eagle somewhere with Louis somewhere on the side. I'm talking about the promotional.
Oh, how I'm going to... A button, Louis C.K.
Louis C.K., yeah, it's going to be great.
It's all America.
Yeah, so that's
what happened with that. Have you seen the super yacht? Super yacht.
Not fuel yacht.
That super yacht crashing into the ocean.
Not
yeah. Bad day.
Oh, wait, this just happened.
Sharp to.
Move, nigga.
Could have been worse.
Oh.
Could have been way worse. Oh, look. That shit looks like you can buff that out.
You can buff that out, yeah. That other boat.
That nigga needs help.
So how do you, like...
How do you stop and exchange insurance information? Yeah,
how does insurance work on boats? Like, do you just, like... Right, now... Do you just get insured? Because it's like...
When you have the money, you just know.
Because it's like, how do you... How can someone... How can... An insurance company, they...
Who's at fault?
I know who's at fault on that one. But they barely want to insure cars.
Facts.
But they're insured, like, if your car is a certain price, they won't insure you anymore. You can't insure a Bugatti.
Oh, right.
You can't insure, like, supercars like that.
So how you
like
drive
that.
Without... An insurance. Oh, well,
you're rich.
You're gonna no, but like, what's the?
You have some type of coverage, but you're rich. Yeah,
so you're putting it under your real insurance.
It's on you. You hit me.
Yeah,
the payouts from you is not from Geico.
Could you imagine? Here's my Geico information.
Here's
nigga.
My Miko.
Niggas using, what's that? I currently have the General.
If you hit the Bugatti, oh my
if
God.
If you hit a Bugatti first
you
up.
Just leave. Like, I honestly, it's like, it's better to just catch me. Like,
really? You think so?
No. But, like, I'm just not
that guy can have you
shit.
Killed.
And, like, at this very moment, I can't stay here because I'm too anxious because I just hit a Bugatti and my Prius. So,
well, if you're Michael B. Jordan, though, everybody will understand. You just left.
Leave.
Yeah. You were that
there's,
or Kevin
there's
Hart.
Clear video of you.
No, but it's fine, though.
Racing and spinning out and hitting several cars.
It's okay.
It's a video of it.
It's okay.
It's your blue.
No, but I had to go.
No one had
I had places
Ferrari.
To be.
Sir, the movie.
I came back.
The movie just came out, sir. Your billboard is right above your accident.
I'm going to be right back. I'm going to be. Nigga's turning to Will I Am. Nigga probably went across the street to the Andaz.
No.
Put some water on his face. Slept for an hour. Woke back up. Said, "All right, let's do this."
We back.
And then you know what that nigga did? Gave the best performance he's given in life to the police officer. Yeah, I had to go. I had an emergency, but I wanted to come back and make sure any damages I took care of.
I'll take care. I'll pay for it.
Oh yeah. I'll take a picture.
Sir, we need your blood alcohol content. Okay.
Okay.
Because the time is past.
Starts texting lawyer.
Yeah. What do we have to do? Get here now.
Get here now. I'm not saying any more words.
Well, I think we have to wait till my representation gets here, and then we'll do whatever.
We can discuss. It's cool if I wait.
Yeah, wait over. I'm gonna.
I think I'm just going in. I'm not sitting around. I'm not grabbing a coffee at a fucking cafe. I'm here.
Perks of being that famous.
If I don't want to be here, I'm going.
I'm gone.
Yeah, my lawyer's here now, so you can talk to him. We can't arrest him.
You ever seen a rich person pay a bill? Like pay a meal bill?
Oh yeah, they don't look at it. They just put the card in.
Oh, that's. I said rich. I meant wealthy.
Well, it never comes.
It just never comes.
Yeah. That's how you know two niggas who sees a wealthy woman. Yeah, it never comes.
Yeah, like you never see a bill. You can just get up and leave.
Yeah.
It's happened to me a couple of times where it's like nothing happened. Where are we?
If you ever watch The Sopranos, it's like Tony eating at Artie's restaurant. You've seen The Sopranos,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So you know how he goes to Vesuvio and he just like eats whatever.
He was like, they're killing us. We don't have the money. They're eating us out of business.
You want to help me, Tony? Pay your fucking tab. Fungool. But yeah, but literally, it's literally like that. And it just turns into, hey, I'm me. Like,
I'm here.
Do you want me to not come back? Here.
You like it.
You like what I thought you
because when I come here, all the pictures and all the
people go,
and then you're in the
and you say maestro,
and then I hug you in front of the and then you get an influ. I don't have to.
Yes, sir. We understand, but you also bring 15 of your friends every time.
Yeah, but every time I come, you get 500 extra guests. With just the 15 of my friends.
No, we cannot anymore, Mr. Levert. We cannot anymore.
Okay, I can't anymore.
Fuck that risotto. It wasn't that good anyway. Nigga, just go out tweeting the risotto.
The risotto was trash.
Nigga, could you imagine like a famous nigga? Like, imagine a nigga like Drake if he has the pettiness level to like create Yelp accounts and give places bad reviews. Like, could you imagine? Like,
and it's just Drake with a picture of Drake is like
he probably don't even do that because he knows nobody will believe it. He just creates accounts and just does it, or he has
but
a Yelp account.
That no one believes it would be him. Would give
it would
more
be funny.
Well, for him to actually do it.
See, I would play 4D chess. I'd have my burner account. I'd type on Yelp, this place is trash, service was awful, blah, blah, blah. And then I'd take a picture of that And then I'd put that out. It, like, damn, this place is losing it. That's what Kendrick would do.
You're a Nigerian. I know there's some Nigerian inside of you.
No.
Fucking scammer.
No. Hey, whoa. Whoa.
Okay, I'm sorry. My bad. I was talking about
Please don't do this. Boat insurance can cover a variety of damages. Listen to all this shit. Boat damage. Boat insurance can cover the cost, repairs, replaces your boat, damage, blah, blah. Property damage, theft, medical payments, fuel spills, wrecked boat removal, towing. Isn't that kind of like wrecked boat removal? But no, they're two different things. Mechanical breakdowns, water sports, fishing equipment.
Now ask, what's the average? What is the average?
For a yacht.
What is the average monthly rate for boat?
Insurance payment. Average monthly rate for boat. Who are you, Ivanka? What is average monthly rate for boat?
Which boat are you talking about?
A monthly rate for a boat.
They're all very large.
Donald.
I don't know.
Monthly rate for a boat.
What is the average insurance payment for the boat? That's what you want to know.
No fucking way. Fuck you.
Oh, no. What is the average insurance payment? I didn't put nothing
boat.
About boats.
You didn't put boat. Okay. Because I saw $83. And
I'm putting yacht.
Nigga, I'm paying $400 for two motherfucking cars.
How much is boat insurance? Boat insurance could cost approximately 1.5% of the boat's total value annually. So, damn. If you got a boat, I know y'all probably don't give a fuck about this, but let's just see what a $600,000 boat's looking like.
That's probably trash.
Nigga, what? Used yacht sales. Look at me. Yeah, the podcast is going great, isn't it? I'm looking at boats and shit. I'm lying.
What money are you hiding?
Mike, imagine. She's like, 600,000 is a very particular number to start at.
I think we're going to have to do an audit.
You're good for those. Nigga's been on an audit frenzy. He's like, hey, you got a label? I should audit it. It'd be a shame if someone were to audit you. Let's see.
Shut up.
Search used yachts for sale. I want to see. Let's just go by price. Let's talk about what is a $600,000. I like $600,000. That sounds like
that's a fair.
I feel like if you're a yacht nigga, what it should be.
That's where you start.
That is the starting point. Yes.
I don't want a yacht that's less than $400,000.
That might be ass. You know, you might be on one of those Bow Wow boats.
Well,
remember those?
Well,
What is the okay? So all of these, none of these were made in the 2000s. That's an issue.
Sailboat.
See, I don't want it. So hey, $600,000, nigga. You're looking at like sailboats and shit that look like it could be on
right
Miami.
Right there, 1993 Palmer Johnson 80. That's a 93.
It's an 80 foot boat, but all your real estate is up front. You got barely any room in the back.
Well, you know, you also go down and then
But that's now you're not outside anymore. Like, so all you getting is this. This is it. Boom.
Yeah, of course. What you thought she was going to be Magic Johnson and Cookie on the super yacht with fucking Samuel Jackson and his wife fucking walking around with Denzel on the backside of the boat.
Okay, so
hanging out and with Quincy Jones somewhere roaming around.
David Geffen shot?
Yeah.
Well, what's that, like $650,000? Imagine.
You know,
look, when the nigga bought it, it probably was. Niggas had money for that long.
Yeah, in 92.
Let's see. I mean, nigga, you're looking at shit like this for $600,000. And that means you're paying about $9,000 to $10,000 a year on insurance.
And then, but then also, it's like the upkeep of a boat. You got to pay for its docking. You got to pay for like someone to continuously do barnacle removal.
Oh, barnacle removal.
Yeah, like, I don't even want a boat unless it's a super yacht. Like, I only want a boat if I can get.
It's the same with a plane for me, like a jet.
I want a
like,
boat after I get my jet.
Yes, I would have been had a jet if I'm looking at yachts.
If I'm looking at yachts,
yeah.
I have a jet.
I have a
16 seater jet.
Yeah, I know the shit got a couch and shit. Like it's comfortable. Yeah. It's not no Boeing 747, but I got a nice jet. Yeah,
It's not Drake's.
No, yeah, no. But
Drake's jet is old though. It's an old plane.
Oh, really?
Yeah, not like old, but like...
it wasn't made in the last 5 years.
You know?
Neither is any flight we've been on in the last...
Kind of heard he's falling off, you know?
What?
Well, okay.
Even you're tired of it now? Yes. Yay!
Yeah.
It's over!
It's definitely over.
Thank God.
Definitely over, because I'm just tired.
Now you niggas will get another song from him in the next
years. Oh, no, don't get it fucked up. I was still in my car screaming Euphoria the entire song for so I know the whole 7 minutes. Just looking like a psychopath in my car. You're moving just like a degenerate. Heavy antics is feeling distasteful. I calculate you're not a calculator. I can even predict your angle. Fabricating stories on the family front because you heard Mr. Morale. Pathetic, masculine manipulator. I can tell the tales on you now. You're not a rap artist. You a trap. You a scam artist with the hopes of being accepted.
You think he could buy a yacht? Yeah.
He released that song
under his label. Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
He has the highest grossing rap song.
Oh, I'm aware.
Indie.
He could rent a yacht every day. And be fine. And you know, at some point, that would cost more than buying the yacht, people. So I'm getting at you know, he has that kind of money.
He could fun coupons. Just fun coupons.
Yeah, literally.
Like, bro, that the amount to drop that song when you go indie, it's like that being the one of four songs that you dropped in your indie experience. Is you can't ever hate on Kendrick. Oh, Rick Ross came out and started talking about 50 Cent again because 50 Cent started talking about Rick Ross, and then Rick Ross was like, "Oh, it's weird. It's weird, 50. Isn't Dr. Dre your boy? But you over there running with Drake." I said, that's what I said. Because I was so confused. I was like, why wasn't he with... Yep, right. Right.
What is it with you and Ross that's just been going on for so long?
I spent it to you, right? Nothing else works.
That's not true.
For him. Outside of mentioning me.
That's not true.
When things get bad, he mentioned me.
He's trumping.
It gets covered further. You see TMZ
is doing the hands too.
50 Cent said this is gonna be bad for Irv Gotti's career. I get covered across the board.
Yeah.
They get covered on the hip hop blogs.
That's true.
It is what it is.
Yeah.
And you watch because I have nothing else to say. You just see it happen periodically.
Yeah.
As it goes.
Okay.
So but no, you say little shit and then
it's like he just bought the Holyfield mansion. Damn. He bought a jet. Damn. Oh no, 4th annual car show? Damn. I just seen a clip of the Wallow show where he was interviewing 50 Cent and the other little dude asked him a question, small talk. But
this show, you know what though? All this shows me though that like this nigga Rick Ross always had a plan. Like, he's not a happenstance, I had a hit song, and I figured, like, this nigga was going, if he didn't make it rapping, he would have been on the internet doing some funny
shit.
He's
a hustler.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
and then even before he made it rapping, he was running around Miami writing everybody's shit.
Oh, I didn't know that.
That's he crazy. Was, like, that had Cypher's Yeezy before his mouth wide, before the jaw. Mm. Like, he was running around writing people. If you watch their Wayne interviews, where Lil Wayne was, like, before he even dropped Hustlin', Ross was around. Like, Ross was like, he's literally the pin behind some of your favorite pins.
So what was he a CO?
Life is long.
Sometimes it's a little too long.
Yeah, life's long. Life has seasons. He could have became a CEO when he became 18, 19, right out of 20.
That nigga looked old in that picture.
He didn't. He had no facial hair. That nigga was probably 23. Yeah, exactly. Big ass nigga was probably 23. That nigga probably needed a job. And then also, CEOs is corrupt as fuck. Like, there's nobody can tell me, you're an upstanding citizen or you're a cop. You think all them niggas got guns? I'm not guns. Cell phones. All them niggas got drugs. Yeah. All them niggas got all that shit. How?
Yeah. CEO. And you have to literally, I mean, unless you're just like not fucking with any of your prisoners. Like, you kind of have to.
And that's a terrible life. You have to deal with them. Yeah. And it's a terrible life to live to be the nigga that everyone hates.
Oh, yeah.
You know. Why not? You in jail, you probably like all the niggas in there. They're your boys. Like, you know what I'm saying?
So, but you don't want to get too friendly either. And that's a fine line. I watched 60 Days In, and I always think about that. I'm like, this is a fine line.
I was watching 60 Days In, and then I ended up watching like 4 hours, and I was just like.
Because it's, you know.
This bitch telling on herself.
There are people writing grievances about you guys, and they're going to send them in. I just want you to know. It's like, nigga. Then they found the other guy. He was, I digress. But it's a great 60 show.
60 Days In.
60 Days. Yeah, exactly.
He said, what?
Oh, y'all crazy. I think they're on to me. A 60. Wait,
finish Rick Ross so we can finish this.
Ultimately, 60. The question that should have been asked was, you jumped out there during the beef, the West Coast versus the Canadian. And I thought Dr. Dre put you on. I thought Dr. Dre was the set. I thought you was loyal to Dr. Dre. You mean you went with the Canadian over Dr. Dre? Who you say changed your life?
What is this? Is this in Vegas?
I thought.
No, this is Atlanta.
Loyalty.
That's Holyfield's house that he bought.
But you did shut the fuck up once the Canadian.
I always have to laugh at that.
What?
It doesn't matter what you spend. That's what? You didn't say that's Rick Ross' house. That's Holyfield's house.
Damn.
You see what I'm getting? That's why it's kind of like, and what did 50 Cent buy?
Mike Tyson's house.
And that's what those places are. And then what was the other house that Rick Ross bought? Evander Holyfield's house.
Yeah, damn.
But niggas always remember the boxer who owned the house. It seems like, because I didn't even realize all these different boxers, but it's like, yeah.
It's like you have to wait for the boxer with all the money to build this grandiose thing to themselves.
And then lose it.
And then lose it. Or sell it, yeah. A rapper comes along. You built this with $50 million, I give you $20.
That nigga got Evander Holyfield shit for like $8.
Yes.
You're just sitting there. What? These niggas are squatters.
The biggest property in the state of Georgia or state of Atlanta. It's like some.
It's bigger than the governor's mansion.
It's like the biggest property. Yes, nigga. Are you talking about the governor's mansion in Buckhead? You drive past, that's on that big estate, and the cop station is like by it or around it.
And
or
that's
like
nice.
That. Well, I mean, that's in. It's in the nice part of Buckhead. Because, there's levels to Buckhead.
Just like there's levels to these here hills.
Speaking of, your kind are coming to Atlanta and just ruining.
What, Chicagoans?
Yes.
Hey, niggas got to find another way because it's probably still cheaper out there than it is in Chicago.
No, what niggas do, what I think happens, I don't know.
But New Yorkers, too.
That's exactly where I was going at. Niggas catch a body.
And they just
do something crazy illegal.
What year is this?
And they just moved to Georgia.
No, what year is this? Like, niggas used to do this back in the day, too. But
the fact that Georgia still allows you to be able to do that.
And they just won't. They want extradition.
They where are they going to find you?
Because so much space.
In the Georgia woods. Where? I live in a bedroom that my friend rents.
Right.
What do you mean you're going to find me?
In the Georgia woods.
You don't know that I went to Georgia from New York.
And then
I don't even have ties here. It's just everybody knows you kill somebody in a metropolitan area, you go to Georgia.
Damn. And then you could just be in Georgia. You can be in Alabama. You could be in.
Yeah, just get wrong.
Nowhere.
You go to New Orleans. You don't want to go to New Orleans because they the cops don't play.
It also seems like you want to go to places that are a bit more like,
Yeah.
And I feel like all those places are like, yeah. They still have sundown town.
Yeah. Come on over here.
Yeah, no, niggas shouldn't be this way after six.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, so just as long as you don't get them over
no,
here.
No, you should know.
So it's like, people just dip out to Atlanta and it's like chill. And so, you know, a lot of those kids crash outs in Chicago and everything like that. Cleveland too, you know, different places, but a lot of crash outs, they'll do some crash out dummy shit and then they'll move to Atlanta. Chief Keef did it. Chief Keef did some crash out dummy shit and moved to LA.
Right, yeah. But he's, man, I'm so happy of how he's thrived.
He's maturing.
Matured so much.
He
has a store on Melrose.
I'm so proud of that boy.
Mm-hmm. He even talks different.
Yes. He's like, he's fun. Like, you could see he's enjoying life.
He built a personality.
He first started, Chief Keef was just like Asperger's. He was just like,
how old are you? 300.
Yeah. That's all. He's joyful, happy, able to elaborate on things.
Able to elaborate. That's a crazy sentence, but it's true. Like, no, this nigga, bro, he elaborating now.
Yeah, he's
elaborating. How's the food? Shit good. Now he says, how's the food? Hey, shit good, bro. Hey, who the chef who made this?
You're like, who are you? Who are you, sir?
Glow Gang.
Yeah, man. Also, Sit Go by Chief Keef is one of the best songs ever created. And I just...
You know Sit Go was a gas station, right? I'm just saying,
Are you asking me, did I know?
Did you know that?
Sit Go... Nigga, I'm from the Midwest!
No, I'm just making sure. I'm making sure that you saw that you saw Sit Go.
You thought I was like, oh, where'd that name come from?
No. Sit Go. That's not even one of the best oil company names. Sit Go is like, what, City Go? Is this where we're going?
I mean, the way I found out Lexus was named Lexus, I'm sure Sit Go is that.
Sit Go.
City Go.
Fueling good. Whoever did that should be fired and or shot. Fueling good.
Did we talk about the Venezuelans taking over the...
Venezuela. So they're taking over Aurora, Colorado.
Allegedly, I'm saying allegedly with a lot of the things because I don't know if this is right propaganda and they're blowing it up to become a thing so they can be like, we got to get these Mexicans out of here. And they're like, they're Venezuelan, bro. Chill. Like,
I don't know. These are
SOS help. Wait, are they... It looks like they going into their boy's house.
It does, kind of.
Let me tell you how crazy this is.
Well, I've seen his video.
Venezuelans is taking over.
They just jacked him.
Oh, me.
But like we said, we did just do the research. Venezuela is having problems, and people are leaving Venezuela.
Yeah.
And when you go to Colombia, Medellin, there is a heavy Venezuelan population. Like, a lot of the people there are from Venezuela because they're trying to escape.
Escape, right.
A boat comes through right here? So right here where we're standing, is this where the Venezuelans came with the guns?
Oh,
we started pointing out the people in the video that we saw on the internet. And right here in this window, it's obvious that a bullet was shot right through there.
Okay.
So do you believe that gang activity is actually happening here? Nah. I'm standing here in Denver, Colorado, and here...
He is the gang activity, though.
That guy that he's asking?
Yeah. In Aurora.
How does he...
TDA. Train TDA. De Araguas. That is a Venezuelan gang that has taken over this city of Denver, specifically Aurora. We're going to go in here and see if we can talk to this area.
He probably spray painted that.
¿Y qué está haciendo los bandidos?
Pues lo que siempre, robar, meterse a todos los conjuntos,
sacar
cosas de los mercados.
All of that.
And
have you heard about others
aquí,
being extorted nearby?
Que han sido, extornado?
No, por aquí no.
Here, no, but the other side, there was a lot of it. Not over here, though. We pack our heat.
They ain't extort shit over here.
What kind of crime do Train de Aragua's commit in Venezuela?
I'm sorry,
here in America,
I don't, those fingers in the hands.
They're just fingers, and they're just hands.
The main apartment complex that has been shut down due to rumors of Venezuelan gangs such as Train
so
de
like
Aragua.
I said before, it's probably really happening, but it's like they're not going to the best of neighborhoods.
I feel like the internet's probably making it a lot worse than it actually is. Like, yeah, they probably...
giving people ideas, too.
It's probably a lot of Venezuelans that have migrated over there. And so now they're like, they're a gang and they're coming.
I see you.
And so, like, they are populating that building, but...
but it's really only 20 niggas. And
it's really only 20
out of 300 who have just moved
like the
to
gypsies,
the area.
You know how the gypsies move around, yeah, and like they have like 30, 40 niggas in one fucking caravan or something like that. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that makes sense. Damn, that's tough.
It's crazy. Where else we going with this?
Let me see. There is...
I'm getting so many text messages from Democrats.
About what?
Vote.
You gotta get out and vote.
And I just keep on texting, stop. Leave me alone.
Where is the...
what's happening there?
Well, I don't know. Drilling contractor accidentally punched a hole in the Queens... Oh! Wait. So the contractor
accidentally punched a hole in the Queens Midtown tunnel, causing water from the East River to spew into the tunnel. The incident forced officials.
Oh shit!
An hour. Oh yeah, he's fucked.
Oh, that's crazy.
Well, not losing a contract,
but bro, like, because if that shit.
Yes.
Oh, niggas.
It's all pound.
I know. It's
the pressure is building upon it. They fucked with the integrity of it, and now water's rushing in, so it's probably going in, forcing down, and like different layers of pressure. That shit could just collapse.
And who's fixing this? Because now you have to repair this and then stand by your work.
I don't want to fix that.
I don't want to be responsible for that. Let's see. There was another video. The shooting. There's this, just a shooting in...
Michael Keaton, and then you just hit
a shooting. No, what about Michael Keaton?
That's just, I love him, and Beetlejuice 2 is coming out. He's been my favorite actor since I was a little boy, and I just wanted to let everybody know that. Go watch Johnny Dangerously. I used to cry when I watched Jack Frost.
Also watch Birdman. Very good movie.
Incredible.
Very, very good movie.
Like, that was like... I loved that movie, and I was like 19 when it came out or something like that.
Yeah, because I was young too. Yeah,
right. Like it came out. That was his comeback.
That shit was great. It was shot mostly one shot.
Yeah. Well, a lot. Yes.
Yes.
But they edited it to make it look like the entire thing was one shot. There's only one shot in that you can be like, oh, they faked that. Now, there's a bunch of other shots that
I know
which
one you're talking about.
But
when he's doing the spread,
that's the only time I'm like, oh, they cheated that.
Yeah.
But other than that, you can't even tell where the cuts are.
For sure you can't. You can't at all. All right. Unfortunately, there was another shooting in Alpache High School in Georgia, what we were just talking about. They're saying multiple patients with gunshot wounds.
So another school shooting. The fact that I am desensitized.
Four
to
dead
this,
and about 30 injured at Appalachian High School.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
In Georgia. The fact that I am desensitized and that I can see four kids have died and 30 kids were injured. Might not all be kids, but there are kids included in that. And the fact that I'm like, yeah, it's been a minute since the last one. What is wrong?
No, facts.
And then I read somewhere, Texas.
He's like 14 too, apparently.
He was 14. You know they're giving guns to the teachers in Texas now. They did it.
Oh God.
some teachers, some not all of them, but some teachers in Texas are armed. And now I'm like,
that's not good either. Though
a teacher will shoot a student just for pissing them off.
I mean, a human being will shoot a human being for just pissing them off. If especially if you go too far.
But an unhinged, undeveloped brain student is
going to piss you off.
Or he charges towards you in anger.
Takes
your gun. Or he gets up fast and you pull and shoot. But he was just, if you didn't have a gun, he would have just
left. So now we have cops in schoolrooms.
Yeah.
Which is, that's
and I would, oh my God, classrooms. I would be terrified if any of my teachers had guns that I went to school with.
What you gonna do, Miss Clark? Yo, bitch ass, Miss Clark. What fuck you gonna do?
Sit your punk ass down before I make change.
My Miss Clark got a hotline.
No, sit your $2 ass down before I make change.
So that's Miss Clark. Miss Clark was black. What you gonna do? What you gonna do, mister?
Yeah, buddy. You done fucked with me for the last time. Hey. And I told you, Jamal. I fucking told you, Jamal, to stop fucking with me. And you just kept doing it. I've been having a bad day.
Mr. Johnson.
No. Keep doing the thing you've been doing. Keep saying it. You kept saying nigga. You kept saying nigga. Nigga this. Nigga that. I told you to stop saying nigga. And you wouldn't stop.
Jamal did not have to lose his life in that classroom last week by the hands of Peter Johnson.
Mr. Petrelli,
that's it. John Petrelli.
JP was always a great guy, and I think you know, the pressure of being a teacher just got to him.
Got to him, man. The question is it's really. What are we doing to fail these teachers? How are we failing these teachers? You know?
Wow.
That's how they're going to spin it.
For sure.
That's how they always spin it. It's all right if you're all white.
Protect teachers.
Yeah. Yeah.
I come to school and I go through a metal detector. And so I ain't got nothing on me. And then I get shot in the classroom.
I bring a gun and I shoot somebody. They're like, Black Lives Matter needs to be disbarred. It's like, what the fuck? what do I? What? I did it.
Me. You know what I hate? I hate the fact that they love throwing not just people from either far right or just racist people. They love throwing the Black Lives Matters thing in the zeitgeist, but here's what I hate. What I hate about it is, they'll be like, "Yeah, Black Lives Matter like stole all this money and did X, Y, and Z and blah blah." But then I'm like, "Okay, fair. Now tell them the people that did it." But it's like, no, I can just say Black Lives Matter, and then go on to the next thing,
and then everybody jumps on. Well, Black Lives Matter, you know they. They're buying houses and they're
giving, but it's not any people who are black.
They're doing this. No, it's just Black Lives Matter.
Yeah, exactly. And I hate that because I'm more angry on both sides. I'm angry that somebody made an organization using a plight.
I'm tired of white people hijacking our
causes,
words, shit, and then using them and turning it against us.
Well, it's
they constantly
but
do.
No, I won't lie though. Part of the problem is them using it for good too. So, like for example,
woke.
No, woke is the prime example. Nobody, if only black people kept using woke the way we was using woke, realistically, it wouldn't have been a problem. I guarantee you. But once they started.
They got it.
Once they got it, and they were like, "Oh no, I'm gonna be woke.
This
I'm gonna
woke
be
ideology.
Yes,
they're doing woke agenda."
But then the people get But see, the people who say that shit are the last to hear it. But they've now heard it from white people who are so liberal they want to be a part of it. That's all I'm saying. It gets watered down and fucked up because it's not really like I remember during like the protests and all that kind of stuff. Over on 3rd Street at the Grove, somebody had a video of this where it was like a black woman was telling, it was some white girl or something. You could tell she was very like,
yeah,
very liberal. You could just tell by the way she was presenting herself. And she's running over, got a mask on, and she's spray painting like Black Lives Matters or something. And the black woman's like, "Excuse me, what are you doing?" No, like that. Don't. She's like, "What?" She's like, "That's not for me. Like that's none of that is for." And it made a point, but that's my point. It's like, yeah, you're the one who's fucking it up.
You're the one who's fucking it up.
It's not because if we're just doing it, it's a direct problem for us.
Yeah.
And it looks a lot different, but it's almost like, hey, this is what I feel like certain white people need to understand. You know, you can help the team in a multitude of ways. Mm-hmm. And then there's certain ways you just need to leave to.
Let us do it.
Yes.
Let us tell you.
Yeah. Can we dictate?
Yeah. Let us tell you what we think would be the best
approach. So look, we're trying to get some money to fund a new center in the community.
This would be the best the best thing you can do. Now you taking your own like advice and being like, I'm going to go vandalize.
Yeah. No.
A community. And it's like, whoa, wait, no, little white girl.
Wait, slow down. Slow down, little white girl. Why would you do that?
Why would you do that?
Well, because everything's just so unfair. Yes, we know that.
Trust me, we know.
We know. No, don't you worry. We've heard it's okay, about little it.
White girl. And then because when I hear woke, all I hear is aware. To this day, I hear aware. So stay aware.
I hear Childish Gambino.
Stay woke. But your breakdown of stay woke is aware. Stay awake. Keep your eye open.
Keep talking.
White people came and said woke. But whenever they put it like woke ideology, you're like, wait, aware ideology? That's kind of playing against what you're talking about.
Because sounds like darkness.
Stay aware, huh?
Daylight. I'm ready for the dark to know this to write.
Boom, boom.
I'm ready for the pop to know this to write. I'm ready for the light to write. Do, do, go. If you want boom, it, boom. Yeah, yeah. Now stay woke.
Stay aware.
niggas creep. I ain't gon' find you. Can't you sleep? Now stay woke.
Stay woke.
They be creeping.
Niggas creep. Close your eyes.
I'm lost at all words from that point.
Only part of the second verse I know is my biggest soda left the cream with Kool-Aid. It's something so racist.
That just sounds so black.
It's funny because it's like my peanut butter chocolate cake with Kool-Aid or something.
And you know what's so great about that? That's one of those lines, literally, even you saying it, I'm like, oh, I can visualize every single word and it means nothing. It can mean whatever you want it to. Oh, these are all things I like. Yeah. These things are sweet, but salty and savory. come up with whatever bullshit.
Is that what he means?
Come up with whatever bullshit you want. That shit is really basically just like all these things. Like when you say it again.
My peanut butter chocolate cake with Kool-Aid.
So you know what I just saw? Death, a birthday, and then a kitchen with a refrigerator that's very small and the bulb isn't on it. But it had one of those pictures with the little...
I saw that too. Yeah. Whenever I hear Kool-Aid, I think of the clear pitcher.
Oh, but
with
so
the handle on it and the blue top.
You know what I thought?
You spin.
I thought the beige. Yeah, I went back. I went back to like, things aren't that nice.
I was thinking clear.
No, see, you're okay.
Not extremely clear, like a stained clear.
Okay. See, I just feel like you're taking black coal. You're taking the Kool-Aid and you're making it like what white people make lemonade. And don't do that. That's not what it.
Fuck that.
No, it's.
I'm talking about the cyclical container. It's like a circle like this, but it's like this big. And it goes this, and it has a handle. It has a little stout at the end, and the white part is a stopper. You put that part in, and then if you put it to the front, you can pour it. You turn it to the side, then, and it has two sides to the back. It has a line version, so it slows down the pour, and then it has an open hole, so the pour is fast, and then all the other sides are just...
I saw this and a nigga can't find the lid.
I saw that.
He can't find the lid, so he puts the little...
So I'm seeing, me and you saw the same thing, different color, different tops.
Okay. That's a Kool-Aid pitcher. That's what niggas drink Kool-Aid out of. No, none of this. No.
Yeah!
Oh!
Now stay woke.
That's exactly what I described.
And he can't find the top.
And he can't find it. And you can't find the oak. Yeah. You gotta, yeah.
Or it's somewhere under the cabinet.
Oh, it's under the cabinet, yeah. Left side. That's where it is.
That's crazy. Man, that's great. See?
See the clear with the red top?
Oh, that's the one you were talking about. That's the one I was talking about. That feels like a, yeah, okay. Yep. That's the new generation version of that.
Because you want to see red.
Right.
I'm drinking purple. This one's green. You don't like green?
And you're right. And all down here, it's just all a little stained.
Yeah.
And just like the Tupperware containers.
Bro.
From that one time you had pasta, and remember?
We still eat it.
Oh, yeah.
Because we know it's clean. Yeah. It has a tomato sauce tinge. Burnt into the plastic.
Yeah, because we was heating up the plastic anyway. Sure. Now what?
But that's just ain't nothing but some flavor. Ain't nothing.
We
but
not
flavor.
Woke.
Stay woke, niggas. Creeping. Okay. Where are we going next? Yeah. Whenever he starts looking at the phone, that means he's like, maybe we can wrap it up.
No. There was another article I had that I wanted to check out. Uh-oh. Yeah.
Oh, the debate?
No, not that. Oh. I mean, that's coming up. Former aide to two New York governors is charged with being an agent of the Chinese government.
Look at that.
And here's what's crazy.
And that case right there, too. The suspect arrested the white girl that got killed. But we don't have to go on that right now. But
okay, we'll look at that.
We always talk about when a white girl gets killed.
I mean,
I'm not trying to minimize her passing.
When any American gets killed,
that's not true.
No, when any American gets killed, and
no, we
can discuss it,
but the public, only see certain stories.
Oh well, of course, yes. That's what. Well, we make a point to make sure that certain things are.
Yeah.
A former aide to two New York governors was charged Tuesday with acting as an illegal agent of the Chinese government who used her state positions to subtly advance Beijing's agenda in exchange for financial benefits worth millions of dollars. Also, they probably didn't kill her family. Linda Sun, who held numerous posts in the New York state government, including deputy chief of staff for chief of staff. How deep does this run now?
Yeah.
Who did she hire?
Bro.
Are they just going to get rid of everybody Chinese now?
We've been compromised. We're compromised.
Well,
I think every agency that we believe, I think everything's been compromised.
Yeah, well, I think in all places, though. So I think So I think it's over. Like, there's an American over there in Russia who's doing our bidding, or a Russian under American. There's Chinese people in our government doing. But I think it's one of those things where maybe there's only a handful who aren't found out. I think in all these governments, they know that if they had nobody, it'd be a bigger problem. So it's like certain people, they're like, let them do their thing. Like, did they really just find out about her? Probably not. It's like when they're trying to put a drug case against you or anything else.
They're like,
we're going to let you.
What happened? Like,
yeah.
Did she see a Chinese flag and be like, and then somebody was like,
They're like, Linda's been acting a little funny.
I'm not saying, but I'm just saying.
I mean, every time we talk about banning TikTok, she seems pretty against it. I don't know. Linda's son held numerous posts in New York State government, including deputy chief for Governor Kathy Hochul. Remember the one who said that kids in the Bronx, black kids in the Bronx, don't even know what computers are.
Why is she popping up so much?
It's terrible. Well, because it's New York.
I'm just tired of seeing new old white women in Congress.
She was deputy diversity officer for Governor Andrew Cuomo.
Well, there goes our DEI.
She was arrested Tuesday morning along with her husband, Chris Who. Who? Chris Who.
Oh, Chris Who.
Yeah.
Who?
Chris.
Who?
Yeah.
Yeah.
At their $4 million home on Long Island.
$4 million home? Is she still being a spy? What the fuck is wrong with her?
What if you want?
Can the Chinese government kill you on? Well, yeah.
It's not about you. What about the other sons over in the other who's and the sons over there?
They,
them niggas is in the trenches right now. Federal prosecutor says Sun, at the request of Chinese officials, blocked representatives of the Taiwanese government from having access to the governor's office and shaped New York government. Oh, so they needed to blame this on her.
Oh, she's the scapegoat.
Yeah, she's probably the scapegoat. Shaped New York governmental messaging to align with the priorities of the Chinese government, among other things. So basically, yeah, okay. I mean, were they really trying to rock with Taiwan?
Go to jail. Go to jail. Do your 2 years, 3 years. It's not going to be that long. Well, maybe it is.
No, it's a problem.
It's good. How much time?
Because now I probably can't stay here.
No. You're fine. You'll stay here. Well, you're going to have to give us all your Chinese government secrets, but you'll be here. You want to go to Club Fed, right? You want this federal, so we can put you in a nice prison. You'll be with Ghislaine. Maybe you can make friends with her. Maybe you can go.
Wait. When are you going in? In like 2 months? Don't know if Ghislaine will still be here.
No, actually, we need you to take care of something for
Yeah, there you go. Hey, listen.
You're a spy. You do this.
Hey, listen. $4 million house in Long Island. How about we make it $8 million?
We just need someone to disappear. Go to sleep.
Poof.
Get it? Where are the fucking documents, Ghislaine? I'm sorry, now I'm over here thinking yeah. about where.
Oh, he just did, Sam Friedman? Is that his name?
Yeah.
Yeah, Sam Friedman just did an interview with Trump. And Trump said on there, he was like,
I'm not on the list.
He said, I'm not.
I don't know that.
He said, I'm not on the list. It's, you know, it's a difficult situation because, you know, people could get hurt. He said,
People could get hurt.
He said, the Kennedy thing. You know, it's been a very long time. He's like, you know, so sometimes they like to redact things to, you know, to protect people.
Oh, he was really like,
he said, well, you know, I get in there, I'll look it over. It was him being like, he was like, yeah, I'd do it. But it was one of those I'd do it that's like,
nah, yeah, I'm not going to do it.
Yeah. I've never been to his island. A lot of powerful people. A lot of powerful people.
You've never been?
Never been.
Not once. Don't know the guy. Never met him.
Not really my kind of place.
This not you? No.
No. So, she achieved in return. Federal prosecutor says son, at the request of the Chinese officials, block representatives of Taiwan. Blah, blah, blah. In return, her husband got help for his business activities in China, a financial boost that prosecutors said allowed the couple to buy their multi-million-dollar property in Manhasset, New York. A condominium in Hawaii for $1.9 million and luxury cars, including a 2024 Ferrari.
That could be Jordan. You want a little bit of this.
Linda's son, Jordan. Son also received, go back. They said, no, we getting this other view. We need this money. We're ABC. Son also received smaller gifts, the indictment said, including tickets to performances by a visiting Chinese orchestra and in ballet groups and Nanjing-style salted ducks that were prepared by the personal chef of a Chinese government official and delivered to son's parents' home in New- Wait. So she got tickets to... What is this? Tickets... Stop it. So she got tickets to a ballet show.
Yeah.
She got salted ducks.
Why are we act? She's rich. What? She has a $4 million house and a Ferrari. Why are we questioning anything?
No, but you know why? Because it's all coming from Chinese government type stuff. Like, it's like you couldn't.
No, I got Chinese family. My uncle.
That's another thing. They probably all did pretty well, so it's not really that funny. Yeah.
Yeah. My uncle, you know. Yeah.
Who?
Chinese son. Who, son.
Your uncle?
Who?
Who?
You? No, I. Oh, no. Oh, no. He said, I'm me.
I'm
me. No, I'm you. No, stop playing with me. Now, who is you? I am me.
Hey, who are you? I am you. That shit, yo. Even like, if that's such a softball for a Rush Hour joke, and now people would have such an issue with that. If people are gonna watch this, it's gonna be like.
But see, that's the thing.
Like, I'm gonna be like, who the fuck is that?
Well, I know. That's why I know everything I say. Like, cause like the way I look at things, like I'm teetering a line because it's like I like that shit. Yeah. Like I like. Line crossing.
It makes me feel alive. I'm a proverbial line stepper. What was that?
He's a habitual.
Habitual.
That's not the first time Rick crossed the line, and we had to beat his ass. Rick is a habitual line stepper. And that line was so funny because that was the first time I ever heard the word habitual.
Nigga's a habitual. Wait, what movie is that from?
Nigga, that's Chappelle's show.
Oh,
that's Rick James.
Yes, it is. Habitual.
He was like, that wasn't the first time Rick got out of line and we had to whoop his ass.
Fuck your couch, nigga.
No, whenever I get kicked out of houses, I say, I've been kicked out of better houses than this. Anytime, even if I have to just leave.
I wonder, A, I believe Rick James used to say shit like that, and B...
You don't have to believe it. It's like...
And B, think of the nicest homes Rick James got kicked out of. And then think of the nicest homes that you would have thought Rick James should get kicked out of, and they were like,
man, it's Rick!
That's crazy.
He's stepping on our couch in his muddy boots!
Yeah, that...
Slapped my wife. He punched my brother in the face.
It was all at my wedding.
Like, my brother and him fought in the hotel at my wedding. Like, yeah, bro. Like, Rick is a talented crackhead.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Rick was a talented crackhead. Yeah. Now, well. You know what?
Yeah.
I have to be a little bit kinder because he passed away and I don't want to be. And actually, I went to see the Rick James show and I met his daughter. And just so, like, to actually be speaking like that
I know, sure.
is rude. No. So, like,
and it's comedy, but I get what you're saying.
It's super comedy.
Yeah. And, I mean, he did the Chappelle thing, so it's not like if Rick James was alive, it's and not Rick like James he would be like, that's not
true. Running around doing crack and coke. Yeah, like, yeah, that's what he's doing. Like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, but
he incredibly was talented,
just like a crack
and like a rock star too, though.
But that's all that mixed together, and you're Rick James, so you be wild. But you're doing the rock star shit as a nigga.
Oh yeah, that's like what he's kind of what Lenny Kravitz would be if he was a nigga for real.
Lenny Kravitz is Jews.
That's what I'm saying. He's Jewish. Yes, he's moving as such. Rock star Jewish guy. Yeah, but
very
like.
Very well eaten. Like, he eats very well.
I
only wear leather.
Man.
I go to the gym and I got my leather pants on.
Go. Go.
I am the gym.
The gym finds me.
My daughter, hot as fuck.
Yeah.
My ex-wife, hot as fuck.
But I knew that was going to happen.
I'm best friends with my ex-wife's new husband, and we're just cool.
Yeah.
Are you going to go my way?
Yeah, you know what? He also has his own island, too.
Yeah. Lenny Kravitz.
I'm learning. When you make a certain amount of money.
Lenny Kravitz is one of those guys that really got white money.
Oh, no, facts. Yes.
Like, he was Drake first.
His mama was on the Jeffersons.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
So his mom married a Jewish man.
Yes. She knew where she wanted to go in life.
Yeah. I get it.
She said, Lenny.
And little Lenny.
Little Lenny, go on with it.
Little Lenny.
Lenny said, are you going to go my way? Because I'd like to know.
I remember, because you know he always wears those tight leather pants anywhere, concerts, anytime. And I remember a couple years ago, he was performing. Don't play it.
They ripped?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
And little Lenny came out.
Little Lenny. Oh, God.
That's what my cousin Demetrius
Little
called.
Lenny.
He was like, you ain't see Little Lenny? That, I was like, that's what do you crazy. Mean, Little Lenny? And he was like...
This nigga be wearing these pants, don't he?
Look!
He the most androgynous old nigga.
They're all in the world. Black, like tight black, my nuts can't breathe pants.
That's crazy.
Look! It hasn't changed.
Neither have those abs.
No, God,
I know, it's crazy. Good for him. I'm glad life's working out for him the way he envisioned it in his head.
Or is this just PR?
I mean, you know.
Look. It's my ex bitch. It's my daughter. That's my wife. My ex bitch's husband.
Yeah. Like, and we all probably hang out sometimes, and you know.
I still. Fuck.
They come to the island.
No. Yeah.
They all come to the island.
They swing.
They all swing. And what I'm saying, if you're at
if
that,
if we're all the most beautiful people in the world,
why would we not? What else are we gonna do? There's like, I guarantee you, there's like, out of all celebrities, there's probably like a solid, out of all celebrities, A-list, super A-list, there's probably like a solid 15, and it's literally something where it's just like, yeah, I'm just not into that shit, and they're always like, dude, come on, it's not that big of a deal. It's like, I just don't really like, I don't really want, like, you know.
Because even I heard the Avengers were fucking.
Well, we're all. Also, we're the only people. I gotta fuck people who have something to lose, too.
Yeah.
This is why you have a island.
Come over
a la
trailer.
Epstein. Just come. I need people.
We're running lines.
I need people who have things to lose. So if you want to.
Scarlett Johansson. Scarlett
Johansson isn't gonna walk in, press record, and then go do something with me, and then go. Oh my God, look what I just. No, because she doesn't need that.
No one needs to know that Chris Evans and Scarlett Johansson were fucking.
No. No one in the world needs to know that.
No.
Who?
Chris Evans and Scarlett Johansson. Okay. No one needs to know that they were fucking.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
Because if people knew that.
That Chris Evans and Scarlett Johansson were fucking?
Yes, they would be alarmed.
On the allegedly, of course, for legal purposes. Oh, but like.
Purses.
No purses.
Purses.
But no one knows.
That's crazy.
About that.
That's
She's
good.
She's married.
That's good for him, though. He's Chris married, Evans? Too, isn't he?
No, he just fucks.
I'm Captain America. Bro, that's the most American shit I
like. To be, first of all, you're cool ass Chris Evans.
Yeah.
Chris Evans has always been like,
and he's
cool
liked by, yeah, he's liked by all races of people.
No.
Yeah.
Black women love Chris Evans.
I think it's probably a section.
I saw him chopping down a black girl. Like they were like leaving Soho House and walking out, and I saw him like, doing the thing.
Nigga was doing the arms.
Yeah, he was doing the whole thing.
Hey,
then he got the number, and I was like, I know that play.
Hey,
I know exactly what that is.
There's somebody who's watching from afar going, took this dude to hang out with Michael B. Jordan once. All of a sudden, that nigga's just, he was just sitting there method.
That's good. Yeah.
Maybe I should watch Steelo. Yeah.
No, he's definitely, Chris Evans, and then I'm Captain America.
That helps.
Because it's like, Robert Downey Jr., you're married, you got the wife, you already did your...
Yeah, I can't do drugs anymore.
Antics, yeah, I drugs. Can't. Chris Evans can totally, he has a good one in him, like, where you can do, he hasn't done anything wrong.
Yet. Right, no, right.
So like,
I think he's in that last hurrah of like, extremely solid white movie stars. So
Chris
it's kind
Pratt. They got Chris Pratt.
You know, they got Chris Pratt. Oh, he's in, but I'm saying these are the, I feel like these are the last hurrah of like movie titan super, like, because
do you see how easily they turned that nigga in Twisters? They're making him the new white guy, Glenn Powell.
But that's what I'm saying, because I feel like there's a lack there's a lack of movie stars in general. But it's like, okay, so we got to get the white boys who are, like, what's his name is also in that, the one that everyone loves from Dune,
Chris Hemsworth.
No
oh, Chalamet.
Chalamet, yeah.
But that's a little nigga.
Yeah, because I remember him at the barbecue.
When we were at the barbecue, yeah. Darnell's birthday. Timothy Chalamet is a little white kid that loves black culture.
How old is he, though?
I think he's 27,
Everything 28. Cool, though, now is black culture. So if you got the TikTok or you got the...
But, like, you know, like, he's actually, like,
It's more genuine.
He can come to the cookout. I'm not like being like, oh, I don't invite everybody, but literally we met the nigga at the cookout.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, and he was blended in with the niggas.
And he was enjoying every song being played.
Every fucking, I really want y'all to know, me and Maestro were around Timothy Chalamet.
That's still a player, right?
Yeah. Last summer.
Mm-hmm.
And that boy was, it was nothing but niggas. It was an ocean of niggas.
Pan Pacific Park.
Pan Pacific.
Very public place.
Zendaya came with Zendaya. Darnell, so it was our boy Darnell's birthday. Mm-hmm. Darnell, Zendaya's right hand. Zendaya came. You're like, yeah, Zendaya be around it. Her dad, black as hell. Like, yeah, Zendaya be around it. But then Timothy Chalamet came out. I was like, I wonder how this white boy gonna do. That boy started, like, I was like, what the fuck? Like,
At first I didn't even realize who he was, and then you were like, "No, it's," and I was like, "Oh!"
I was like, "Bro, that's Dune."
That's crazy, crazy times.
And then black people was walking up like, "Oh, hey, little Timmy Allen." He was just like taking it, and like he knew how to respond.
Yeah, I mean, you know,
he went to LaGuardia.
Oh, and he's from New York. That makes a difference.
He went to LaGuardia in New York, and there's like, you know, didn't Cardi B go to LaGuardia, or like. Nicki Minaj went to LaGuardia.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like, okay.
I was supposed to go to LaGuardia, and I didn't.
Missed your flight.
No, fuck that. I'm not going back to, like, I was at the Boys Choir of Harlem.
Oh, I remember, yeah.
So I had to catch the subway, because, you know, I lived in Jersey. Uh-huh. So I had to cross the George Washington Bridge and then go on the subway to go to school or come home, or I'll get dropped off. And after that, they were like, you want to go to LaGuardia? I was like, that's like 30, 40 minutes past Harlem. Like, I was like, I don't want to leave. I don't want to do that. Yeah. So, like, I didn't go.
You seem like you were in the Boys Choir of Harlem.
Yes?
Yeah. No, it seems like something you would have done. Like, because I know those kinds of programs. Yeah. And there was, like, ones in Chicago. Same thing. It was like, these are all things. Yeah.
It's a terrible program.
Really?
There's nothing but bad kids in there. I stayed there for 1 year, and I got.
I didn't like it there.
Oh my God! I would come home every Christmas. I would come home on Christmas crying. Like I remember my mom's Christmas present to me was telling me that I can go back to my school that I'd been at since second grade. She was like, "Mikey, you can go back to the."
Oh, that was their test to try to get you around some niggas.
Yeah. It didn't work out.
And then your lady does like, you gotta go to college around some nigga. Yeah. Yeah. Like, at some point,
like,
you
I'm
gotta.
I'm not allowing this, bro.
You're not gonna go forever without it. Like, at least your skin's a little.
Well, it's like,
you got taller.
My cousins and everything, and I grew up with my cousins from Cleveland that are niggas. So, like, I grew up with black cousins around me, but school.
School's different.
Just white kids. Ever since I was little, just white.
See, I always went to really good public schools, but I won't lie, it's almost the same.
As a private.
Yeah, unreadiness, because it was all black kids, but it was all like, it was a different thing. Then when I got to middle school, went to a regular.
Mm-hmm. And then you were like.
Public middle school. Uh-oh.
My mom taught me that to find the house that you're buying or want to live in, you look at the school systems.
Right.
So my mom, when I was younger, with the house when we moved from Cleveland to New Jersey, she followed the school system.
And that's why Alpine made so much sense.
You know what I'm saying? So then when I went to public school.
It was still great.
It's still top of the.
Top of the line public school.
We're actually ranked with
the privates. There you go.
So it's like. But yeah, not all white kids, everything like that. Hey, I ain't no bitch. I was like, you know what I'm saying? But I went to school with the niggas at Boys Choir Harlem, and I was like, oh, these kids have problems. You're like, I'm now mixed in with kids whose parents are like drug addicts. And yeah.
Our conversations are so different.
Yeah. Like, I remember once the teacher said, hey, can you boys get LaMica? And five kids came and grabbed me. And, like, I started, like, fighting back.
Yeah, because you're like, people don't treat me like this.
Yeah, no, yeah. Like, what are you doing? And they grabbed me and pulled me over to the teacher. And I was so confused at that. And, like, during summer camp, because if you went to the Boys Choir of Harlem during the summer, you had to go to sleepaway camp. And you had to stay there for, like, a month. And they trained you how to sing. They made you do all this stuff. Didn't take, obviously. And then I remember I was sitting in the gym. And I was sitting down. I don't remember what I did or said, but this kid picked up a Timberland and hit me in the face, in the eye. And ever since that moment,
I've hated Timberlands.
This black spot in front of my eye.
Really?
It's called a runner. And so whenever like my eye.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I get those every once in a while.
It wasn't there before I got hit with that Timberland.
Really?
And then I got hit with that Timberland. And that's just...
Yeah, I get that every. Like I can
you
see
can't
one now.
You can't train your eye on it because it's always gonna flee. But
it's always gonna flee. That was funny.
But
where'd it go?
Here it go. I tried. Niggas was wild. I was fighting in That's Boys crazy. Choir Harlem. Like I was fighting niggas.
You were in Harlem.
Yeah, and I'm around the white. Like I beat kids up. At Leonia, little white kids Leonia. That are acting like, I'm like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like,
you're the aggressive,
I'm the aggressor. I go to Harlem, I'm fighting for my life. I was fighting niggas all the time. I was so confused. I was like,
why does it have to be like this?
The teacher hit me with a basketball. They hit another kid with a stapler. Like, I was like,
that's how you teach them over there.
Mom,
get me out of this shit.
Please help. That's hilarious. And then I went to, Morehouse, and everything was easier.
Yeah. Sounds about right. No, I'm kidding.
Maestro has the wrap it up demeanor.
Yeah, I think it's time to wrap it up. But, you know,
every nigga deserves to wrap it up.
Every nigga should wrap it up.
Damn.
Wow. Now stay woke.